Hey, it's Anna. Welcome back to Mirror Mirror. And if you're new here, hi, I'm an independent music artist. I write, record, and produce my own music. And I also film 4 series here on my YouTube. And this one is all about relationships because they are the key to life. So for this video, we're going to talk about bullying a little bit, which I have touched on before. I've shared a little bit about my experiences before in my video about when you feel left out. I think that was the video, or maybe fake people. Like, I think I've talked about it a few times, but I want to touch on something that I've come to realize lately, because I have also shared my experience in an abusive relationship, and I now realize that they are pretty similar, which is kind of sad, but they actually are. When you think about the dynamic of bullying, like between the bully and the victim, it is very much, whether it's physical or emotional or mental, it is a lot of abuse and like manipulation and that kind of thing. And then when you look at abusive relationships, they are essentially the same thing. And it took me a little while to even bring myself to acknowledge the fact that they're the same thing, because I feel like there's a lot of shame around being in an abusive relationship, and also a lot of shame in the idea of being bullied. So to try and like bring them together and realize that actually the dynamic is very, very similar was a little bit of a weird thing for me, because I felt like, oh, like it just made me resist it, because it feels like, no, that's just so weird to acknowledge. And also because I feel like in a lot of circumstances, the people that do the bullying, sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes it can be within your own friendship circle. So the idea of that being an abusive relationship or an abusive connection felt weird to me. But now, the deeper that I've kind of gone into this and how I felt back then and those kind of things, I've come to realise that actually it is the same thing. Because one is just with a romantic partner and one is with a friend. Or one is with a romantic partner and one is with somebody that's like more of an acquaintance. Either way, it's the same kind of treatment. Especially because for some people, bullying isn't physical. For me, it wasn't physical. But then in an abusive relationship, it was physical. So there's different ways for all of these things to happen. And obviously, it's not going to be the same for everyone. But I do feel like it's important for me to put this message out there for anyone that's dealing with either an abusive relationship or bullying, is that they're kind of one in the same, because the methods used, the emotional and psychological manipulation and the belittling and like the making you question yourself, making you doubt yourself, the humiliation that you often feel, all of the behavior on their part, and then all of the internalization that happens to the person that's going through it is pretty much the same. At least in my experience, it was the same. And I never realized that at the time of either of those situations happening. But now when I look back on it, I fully see how similar those were. And I really think it's important to talk about, because a lot of people feel shamed around either one of those or both. And also, I do feel like if you are young, like if you're in school and that kind of age, and you experience bullying, I do feel like you're more likely, and this is not a statistic because I have no idea, but from my perspective of looking at it psychologically and somebody's low self-esteem and stuff, to how they kind of experience bullying really lowers your self-esteem and really kind of belittles you, and just, you know, it makes you kind of crumble and like suppress who you are and hide your authentic truth. So when you've already experienced that, I feel like you're more likely to experience it again in a romantic situation, like whether it's abuse or not, whether it's just that somebody's quite manipulative or narcissistic or something. I feel like if you've experienced it in a friendship or even in a family dynamic, the chances of you then going and experiencing it in a romantic relationship is probably a lot higher, because you're used to that dynamic and you kind of accept it as being the way that life is. Especially if it's a family dynamic, it sort of becomes the norm for you, and there's a lot of trauma that gets created that you then obviously need to uncover. And oftentimes in our school years, we're not really doing that. Most of us aren't even taught to do that. So then when you get a bit older and you start having romantic relationships, you're likely to either attract people that are a bit manipulative or choose people consciously that are a bit manipulative or any other kind of scenario, you know. But it's just something that I've uncovered for myself, and I really hope that talking about it helps you in any way, because just being aware of those patterns are so, so powerful. Because then once you realize that actually you're prone to have similar connections with similar types of people, whether that be friendships, family, or romantic, if they all behave in similar ways, you now realize that there's actually an internal issue going on that you now need to address and work through so that you choose better people. Because, you know, we can find ourselves attracting similar types of people when we're unhealed. And the last thing you want to do is spend your whole life being unhealed and connecting with other unhealed people and just having it be so toxic and so draining, you know. Because these relationships are very, very draining, including the friendships and including family, when it's that kind of dynamic. So I just think it's important to be aware of all of it, to be honest. And it's a shame that these things happen and that unhealed people feel the need to belittle other people and to create so much trauma in them that they are then unhealed as well. And we just become a big unhealed mess, you know. And it's a shame that that happens. But I do feel like the more of us that speak about these things and the more of us that actually address the fact that we need to address it within ourselves individually, like each of us, no matter what end of the dynamic you're on, we all need to be able to work through our own shit. So then we stop getting with people like that, but then we also stop bringing that kind of behavior into the relationship on our part as well, you know, and just really unravel these karmic cycles that so many of us get stuck in. So I really hope this video was helpful. Definitely comment down below if you have any suggestions, or you can text and WhatsApp me. Everything about me is in the description box below, as well as links to my music, my phone number, my social media, my jewelry brand, one-to-one sessions, and everything else about me. And I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I really appreciate you subscribing and watching. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. It's always been my mind.